God with the direction of the chief rabbi, does it?
Woo!
I don't think of that. I think of him color chalking our fingertips and the keyboard keys
so even the babies could learn the touch system. Or how he used to make videos of us washing dishes, and then he'd analyze them, and then eliminate our waste motions.
Painting diagrams on the wall of the solar system, and the difference between meters and yards. Tapping out Morse code, telling those that understood where the candy was hidden.
And remember how we used to shout out those two canaries?
The one he named, "Shut up," and the other, "You heard me."
But when I think of Dad, I think of him bounding up the front steps, arms full, bursting to try a new idea. He'd come roaring into the living room. Then he'd pull out his stopwatch and whistle for assembly calls. That meant, you better come running.
Soap in my right hand. Now follow this one continuous motion. from the top of the shoulder, down the top of the left arm, back up the bottom of the arm, and down the left side. Got it? Shift soak. Same motion, other side.
Don't forget the back of your neck.
Hello, boss. I'm not forgetting a thing.
Glad you're home ready. What's on the racket?
Fingernail inspection.
How about yours? Biting them again?
Let's see yours. I told you not to do the dishes yourself.
There's already too much for the cook to do.
I'll take care of that. It's all a matter of saving motion. Dishes are basic. Continuing. Give a little attention to your feet and the back of your neck, and you'll be out of the tub before you can say bonjour. Now you know all about taking a bath. Take the rug back and put the controllers upstairs. I'll go back to the cook.
We'll both talk to her.
Which goes in which bathroom?
We'll give the girls French.
I'm not for French.
Your mom, is that French or German?
I think it's Spanish.
Dad has a system for everything.
Even for conjugating French and German verbs in the bathtub.
If only he'd think of a system for interesting a couple of boys that go to school.
In what?
In me.
Well, a person has to think of some things for herself.
I did. What do you mean?
I'm going to have it out with him.
Have what out?
Well, somebody has to, and I'm the oldest.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to stop dressing like a freak. Aren't you tired of all the boys at school thinking you're a freak?
Yes, but...
That's a... I don't care what he says!
He might hear you.
He's going to anyway. Cotton stockings. No wonder we never get asked anywhere. No boy would dare be seen with us. The way it looks, I'll be the only person to go to Montclair High without once being asked to a dance. Whenever the phone rings, it's just some girl.
A boy called yesterday. He wanted my notes on the Second Punic War.
Gee, you'd think he would impress fellows, knowing things like the touch system and Morse code.
But it doesn't matter at all.
I had to do something. I bought some things, up-to-date things like other girls wear. And they look absolutely snaky.
Careful! He might look in any minute.
Let it! I'm not asleep.
What'd you get?
Short under things and... silk stockings!
Silk stockings?
What would that? They're right in this package. And I'm going to wear them, and I'll be asked to dances, and lots of boys will want to dance with me. And I'll be a really popular girl.
And if Dad lets you wear them, he'll have to let me wear them too.
And me!
And then we'll be going on dates and going to dances.
And we can talk over different boyfriends and compare notes and... Golly! Silk stockings!
And it's Dad!
Find it quick!
Just apply motion study.
Motion study is fine as long as it's somebody else's motion you're studying.
Mrs. Fitzgerald, you better go on with it.
Lincoln frees the slaves all but one.
We'll handle this the same way we would in the factory.
It isn't exactly the same.
Exactly. And what works in the factory?
Yes, dear.
Now, the first job of the family council is to apportion the necessary work throughout the household. Does the chair hear any suggestions? Come, come, fellow members. How do you want to divide the work?
I don't think anyone wants to divide the work or be associated with it in any way, shape, or form.
In a democracy, everybody speaks. So start speaking. Dan, I recognize you. I'm warning you. Speak.
I think Mrs. Fitzgerald and Tom should work. They get paid for it.
Sit down. You're no longer recognized. Bill, I recognize you.
I think Tom and Mrs. Fitzgerald have enough to do. So I think we should hire more people to help with the work.
You're out of order, too. Boss, now what?
Well, we could hire more help. But that would mean cutting back on other things, such as allowances, moving pictures,
new Do
I hear a motion to that effect? Who wants to stop allowances? Moving pictures?
Seriously, we'll all need to help.
I move the boys cut the grass and rake the leaves.
I move the girls sweep, dust, and do supper dishes. And everyone makes their own bed.
Except the chairman.
Except the chairman.
I second the motion. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Now, there being no further business.
Mr. Chairman, I believe our budget of a new bug is intended.
It is.
Can the budget afford such a bug?
Well, I don't know. Sounds to me as if they have a good point, boss.
Well, I plan to spend $100.
I won't do no more than $95 to be spent.
I second that motion. All those in favor?
Aye.
Looks like you lost on that one, boss. Now, there's no other business.
Mr. Chairman, I'm going to spend the $5 we just saved to buy a collie puppy.
Wait a minute.
I second the motion.
Out of order. Very much out of order.
A dog would be a pet. Everyone would pat her, and I would be her master.
A dog would sleep at the foot of my bed, and I would wash her fur when she gets dirty.
A dog would be an accursed nuisance. He would be our master. Nobody would wash his dirty, flea-bitten carcass. He'd positively sleep at the foot of my bed.
Let's vote.
Any pet that doesn't lay eggs is an extravagance.
Vote! Vote! Vote!
Vote! Meeting adjourned, that's it.
All those in favor?
Aye!
No!
I'm afraid you lose that one, boss.
I think the family council is a wonderful idea.
There are lots of things you should take up.
Oh, yes. I'm sure that's the one. Ponies. Roadsters. Trips to Hawaii. Silk stockings.
Mr. Chairman!
What is it?
There is further business I wish to place before the council.
And it's important.
I'll show you. I'm not hiding anything. I want the entire family to see.
Shall I bring down the baby?
Be serious.
What is it?
To begin with, these under things, these teddies, I'm going to wear them.
You will not! Put those back in the box! It embarrasses me to even look at that.
I bought them with my own money.
You'll take this right back to the store.
There's only one girl besides us who doesn't wear teddies at our school. And if you don't believe us, you can come to our school and see for yourself.
That won't be necessary.
I'm glad there's one other sensible girl in school besides you. But she doesn't even wear a teddy.
And if you don't believe us...
That still won't be necessary.
Hey, Ken and Boy, crazy dad.
That's all they talk about.
You should see them eyeing the boys in the halls, at the school, in the lunchroom.
You little snakes!
Shame on you!
You might as well know. It isn't just teddies. I bought silk stockings.
No!
Oh, and!
You might as well go bare-legged as wear these. You can see right through them. It's like the last of the seven veils.
Now you know.
Don't you know what might happen if you go around showing your legs through silk stockings?
What? But that's the way everybody dresses nowadays, Dad.
Boys don't notice when everyone dresses that way.
Don't tell me about boys. I know all about what boys notice.
You don't want us to be wallflowers?
I'd rather raise wallflowers than clinging vines.
Well, I'm going to wear these. I'll not be a wallflower anymore.
And I'm going to buy silk stockings too.
And me!
I won't let you out of the house with them!
Don't you see, Dad? I've never...
They just run around with that.
If you ask me, it's a dead giveaway to be so suspicious. It denotes a misspent youth.
Nobody asked you. Listen to me, Anne. When a man picks a wife, he wants someone he can respect.
They certainly respect me. I'm the most respected girl in the whole school. The boys respect me so much they hardly look at me.
You come back down here. I don't want you wasting your time with a lot of boys. Look at the fun we have right here at home with our projects.
You don't understand! You don't understand at all. I wish your job was selling shoes. You only had one or two children. And neither of them was me.
We should start cleaning the yard. Come on, guys.
Let's give a hand.
Okay.
I'll straighten up the living room.
Good girls.
Boss, what is it I don't understand?
High school girls.
Remember when we first decided to have a dozen children? Remember what I suggested?
You suggested you had all boys.
Now, I'm not blaming you, boss, but you should have followed my suggestions. High school girls. By jingo, there's only one way to handle this.
Just like in a factory.
Absolute waste of money.
How about a
1-year subscription. I'd still save my money. If I were you, I'd ask about short-term subscription. Maybe 6 months. That's a mighty short-term subscription. A man with your responsibilities doesn't want to waste his money.
Mr. Bones, I don't believe a word you say. I feel too good. Besides, I'm too busy.
Fine. I won't have to worry about it. See you next week.
You bet you will.
Hey, Gat. What magazines are you subscribing for?
Never mind. What's this?
We already did our homework.
That's fine, but you don't have to stop there. You always do more. Pretty soon we'll skip a grade.
Dad, I skipped a grade last year.
We'll start thinking about next year. I won't have you held back by a school system geared towards the children of average parents. It's one of the topics for tonight's discussion. Silk stockings.
I've been wearing them at school, and I guess you might as well know it.
The next thing I know, you'll be wanting to paint yourself.
Everyone wears makeup nowadays, Dad.
They don't call it painting anymore.
I don't care what they call it. I'm not having any painted women in this house.
What you want is a house full of old maids.
What I want is for you to get along with things that matter, by yourself, without needing me to hound you all the time.
And the topic for tonight's discussion is skipping grades in school.
Yes, by Jingo and a little better organization around here.
We voted all topics should be of general interest.
Better organization is always of general interest.
That's so smart. Why can't he understand? You poor thing.
Hey, Frank. Your move. Sure about that?
Of course. Hey! Wait a minute.
Another game?
No. Get him out of here!
Of all the dumb dollars.
What do you expect for $5?
Up on Dad's bed again.
He's always on Dad's bed. He's crazy about Dad.
The basement window, across the Colvin, back stairs, Dad's bed.
Dad was right about the dog. Now he'll think he's right about everything.
Clothes, makeup, and everything.
There's still hope when boys will go mad over them.
Over them?
What's so ridiculous about that?
Nothing.
Only what? Do you have anything to say?
I just wouldn't think you had that sort of effect on anybody.
Well, we have known you all our lives.
Thanks for the compliment.
I think you're good swimmers and at tennis.
We don't care for your opinion.
Other boys don't feel like that about us.
Do they?
I've never heard the subject mentioned.
If you want an honest, frank answer,
we don't.
Look, guys, where have silk stockings gotten you so far?
Someday you're going to be surprised. Someday that phone's going to ring. It'll be
someone for Dad.
Here.
Hello? What? Are you sure? You want to talk to who?
Who's it for?
You mean, you want to talk to Ann Gilbert? The one with the freckles? Are you still there? Please don't hurt.
What are you saying?
Imagine it. It's a boy calling for you.
Give me that phone!
Imagine it. For you.
Snake in the grass. Hello? Yes, this is Ann Gilbert. Who? It's nice of you to call.
Go ahead, talk to him.
I can't.
I'll take care of that.
Hey, we were only kidding.
A friend of your school!
A friend of me!
You get it!
What? Oh, no, nothing's the matter. Yes, this is a very good time to call. Yes.
Where have I been all your life?
Well, mostly I've been right here.
Come along!
Of course I'd like to have a soda with you. Wait, you mean right now? At night?
What about that?
You're
And if Dad lets you go,
he might have a project. Don't you see? This is the start. Boys notice girls that other boys notice. I mean, pretty soon you begin getting popular. And then you meet someone you really want to meet.
And if Dad lets you go, then he can't be so strict with us.
No! That's why it's so important. This is the start of everything. That's all. Mother!
Your father will be down in a minute. He has some things for family council to do.
Mother, there was a phone call. A boy called me.
That's nice.
I think he's a very well put up boy.
He's the cheerleader.
He asked me to go have a soda with him.
When?
Tonight. He said he'd drive right over.
He has no car to.
I don't think tonight's a very good night. Maybe some other night.
But if I break the first date I ever had, there won't be any other night.
Please, Mother.
Say something to Dad.
I wish some other time.
But when? When?
Well, I guess you have to start sometime, though.
I already told him yes.
Maybe we can bring it up at the end of the family council. If you'll be especially cooperative, I hope he's the quiet and reassuring type.
Oh, he is!
He's small, too! Only that high!
That's reassuring.
Now let's see if the skull gets fractured.
Bills, put down that umbrella.
Frank, bring your mother a chair.
I was trying to explain things to the dog.
We made a bet by my mother the fudge. He'll destroy the season.
By jingo, he better. I now call this family meeting to order. If there are any topics of general interest you'd like to bring up, hearing none.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to go to the topic of road states.
Not of general interest.
I'm interested.
Sit down.
The trouble is, you always step into general interest, and none of us have a chance. I don't think that's very democratic.
Nonsense! I always favor a fair discussion of general interest before getting to business of the meeting. And I can't recall ever being unreasonable as to the subject matter.
I might sometimes see a boy who's in my history class.
He's the cheerleader.
Not of general interest.
He is. We're all very interested.
Not me. Or Sid. Now, if Ann had said she might sometimes see a two-headed boy, that would be of general interest.
I would be very interested in a two-headed boy.
Now, I have a very first-rate topic. I'm going to teach you a new method of multiplication that's bound to make a wonderful impression on your math teacher. Remember, a lot of little things like this add up to skipping grades in school.
Is that of general interest, Daddy?
That, Jackie, is of the utmost general interest. But before we get into the mathematics, I have an announcement to make. I've been invited to speak at the World Management Conference in Europe. Despite the opposition of a few worriers, I intend to go. But by jingo, I'm going to leave this family in smooth running condition. Is that a big load on your mother?
They're not such a load.
I'm going to organize a purchasing committee to buy food, clothing, and equipment. Then I want you to elect a utilities officer to levy 5-cent fines on wasters of water and electricity. A projects manager will ensure that all work is completed on schedule. Your mother has enough to do as it is.
We'll all help. Of course, Dad. And since that's settled, I'm a wager.
We need more system. I'm installing work charts in the bathrooms if you were to initial after brushing teeth, washing faces, chores, homework, and so forth. Then all your mother has to do is glance at the charts.
I think we're all in agreement. And since that's settled, I'm a wager.
I'd like to see us have the most efficient household in the whole world. That would leave more time for your studies. The most important thing is your schoolwork, your education.
We're all doing fine in our studies. Couldn't we go into that tomorrow?
I want you doing better. Skipping grades now and then. Your schoolwork is the most important thing. Anything that detracts from your homework.
Mr. Chairman, please, I will be adjourned!
I second the motion.
And anything that detracts from your schoolwork. What I was trying to say was. Are you in any way responsible for that noise?
I'm responsible.
Great Caesar's ghost! What's that written on the car? jump in, sardine? Here's your tin.
There's more on the other side.
He asked Anne if she could go for a soda. I think it might be all right.
I've already done my homework.
We have a mathematics project.
Couldn't I get it for Ernestine later? I called this out.
Tell him to stop that. What do you want me to do? Go sit in the kitchen?
We're going to have a talk before you say anything to that boy. He might be quite nice.
He's a cheerleader!
That settles it!
Now, Frank, keep an open mind.
Anyone would think boys are more important than mathematics projects.
Now what?
Hey! The gang's all here! What's the matter? Can you hear me, Hawk?
We heard you.
Some horn, eh?
My brothers and sisters?
The baby's upstairs.
Some family.
You're the first cheerleader we ever saw up close, gee.
How do you like my tie? It's a William Tell tie. You pull the bow, it hits the apple, you see? It's a William Tell tie. You pull the bow, it hits the apple, you see? Say, it's getting late.
We better show off.
I think maybe my dad wants to meet you first.
I think maybe he will.
The gang's all down there. We ought to get going.
Hey, Joe. Do you have time to show us how you lead a chair?
Yes.
No.
Show us a chair. I'd like to see that.
Sure thing.
Come on now. Are you crazy?
I'll show you guys one chair. Then we'll get going, okay?
Okay.
No, don't. What are you worrying about?
Let's have a hoorah ray and a tiger for my clear pie. A hoorah ray and a tiger. I want to hear you holler now. Ready?
Patrollers used to play that song.
Clap hands, here comes Charlie.
stumbling me and the boyfriend?
You gotta see Mama every night, or you can't see Mama at all.
Those tunes remind me of a cheerleader back from Montclair High. I can't recollect his name.
Joe Scales. Some shriek, eh?
Claiming youth has really caught fire. Except at our house.
That's because at our house, we had Dad.
And he acted as though he thought our generation was riding straight for the devil.
In a stripped-down Model T. Suitably inscribed with, "Hey chicken, here's your roost. Four wheels, no brakes, the tin you want to touch."
Those old jalopies were just as good as our own car.
Do you remember riding around in the Pierce era with Dad? How someone would always shout, "I see 12 kids." Dad would always bellow back, "These aren't much. You ought to see the ones I left at home." Or once when someone shouted, "Hey man, what are you doing in that old ark?" Dad would always shout back, "Doing what the good Lord told me to. Collecting animals. All I need is a jackass. Hop in."
The most embarrassing part was when we drive to a toll booth and Dad would play his favorite game. He guessed the nationality of the collector and then, "Hey, can my Irish friend come cheaper by the dozen?"
Irish one it is. Sure it wasn't best for a family like that to pay toll.
Sometimes it was a Dutch collector.
Ah, what a healthy load of Dutchmen. Drive through on the house.
Even without for a drive, Dad couldn't stop teaching. I mean, if we drove by a factory, he'd explain how they use a plumb line to keep the chimney straight.
Because he was always in a hurry for us, with all the projects and the purchasing committee. Were you terrible as purchasing committee or what?
The purchasing committee got wholesale rates on things from underwear to baseballs. And look at the saving of canned food when we ordered direct by the truckload.
And how about the 96 jars of peanut butter?
Everyone likes lots of peanut butter.
Not me. Well, not anymore.
The committees were a wonderful idea. They eliminated waste motions and they made things easier for Mother.
You didn't talk like that back then. Back then, all you girls thought about were boys and dates.
That's because a boy hardly dared to call at our house. That little cheerleader did nearly everything but nail a quarantine sign on our door.
I remember Anne burning up.
I'm living on through what's called hell on earth.
And Dad picked that particular time to step up the efficiency program.
He didn't exactly pick that time.
Well, I didn't mean...
Sure. None of us knew. A lot of times, it seemed like he was in quite a hurry.
Like the time the lady psychologist teacher came to give us those examinations.
We didn't know about the exams. We didn't know it meant Anne could graduate ahead of her class.
Dad's master plan. He was so anxious for Anne to graduate right then, so she could be free to help Mother.
Didn't Anne go to a movie with a boy that afternoon?
Well, she didn't know the exams meant anything. She didn't know Dad had been talking to the school board about graduating her early.
But she missed dinner completely. And she missed most of the exam. Dad was wild.
He kept checking his watch every 3 minutes. If the psychology teacher hadn't been there, he would have been roaring like a lion.
You and I, we finished the exam early, along with some of the others. They must have gone upstairs.
Frank, the music coming from down the street. That's where the control is. That's upstairs.
That's the girl's bathroom.
Oh, yeah, come on, come on.
Before Dad.
Quiet! Shut off that noise! I said quiet! You two! Who's playing those?
I don't know.
And didn't come in? No use trying to get around me now. Turn those off and come down here. Turn them off! That psychology teacher is going to think I made them play those language lessons. She'll think I'm trying to impress her.
Well, aren't you?
How did you do on her trick examination?
Practically perfect.
Me too.
It didn't take you too long to finish. You and whoever's playing those...
Go dinner then.
Bonsoir, compère.
You spend half as much time improving your minds as you do memorizing those stupid songs, you'd be able to recite the Quran forwards and backwards.
Ish means in Abin Heaven. That's Ish Tire Bin. That's called Mun Yish as Dimsin.
No. Let's wind up with the controls and have a little more jazz. Da-da-dee-da-da-da-da. Let's have that record about I'll Love My Sweetie Forever in a Day.
You made that up. That's not a real record.
Maybe so. But take it from me, that's well above average. Da-da-dee-da-da-da-da.
We bought those jazz records with our own money and earned me. Who's to recite the Quran backwards?
Look at those report cards you brought home this afternoon.
What's so wrong with a B average?
Last year you got straight A.
Last year I skipped a grade. It takes a while to catch up.
Just the same. This afternoon is in the drugstore with the boys, drinking sodas and listening to jazz. I told you it wouldn't help your marks, and this proves I was right.
We hardly spent any time with boys.
Ha! We don't have what people will call a normal social life. So people have dates on school nights.
It's practically nights out.
And a school night. Where's your sister?
We told you 10 times.
She went to a movie with a boy.
All afternoon? She missed dinner. She's missing the examination. She knows she should be home.
Bill went with her.
She remembers your rule, a brother on every date.
But she's making him miss the test too. Why couldn't she just bring this boy back to the house instead of going off like that?
Why?
Yes, why?
Because of the way you scared that Joe Scales. He's got the rest of the boys afraid to come down here. Even that friend of mine.
The one with the motorcycle? The one who keeps buzzing around the house at all hours?
He's trying to work on his nerve.
What's he afraid of?
You!
Me? Why should any boy be afraid of me?
I think it's Mac.
We're not telling your father is leaving for the World Management Conference. Only you won't have to work on his nerve much longer.
Anyone graduating ahead of the class. And if she doesn't show up, that's perfectly all right with me.
she'll be back any minute.
What have you learned so far about the others?
The results are inconclusive.
What's inconclusive about that? Have you ever graded a better set of papers?
I'll have to interpret the results.
Interpret? Here's something to interpret.
What's that?
You'll see. Please adapt some more tests.
I'll finish on the dishes.
Hurry, finish the exam.
10 seconds.
Wow.
Doesn't count. Bill and your older sister aren't here.
Oh.
Frank, what's 46 times 46?
2116.
Dan, what's 19 times 7?
323.
Mark, what's 52 times 52?
2704.
Dan.
You coached them.
I taught them. Miss Brill, do you know the capital of Colombia? Do you know the population of Des Moines according to the last census? Of course you do. But so does Dan here, so does Lillian, so does Baby Jane upstairs. I bring her down when it's time for fog.
Now you're being ridiculous.
What's 16 times 16?
Well, I really.
256.
There. What's 17 times 17?
289.
Good job. Boss, we better keep that girl.
Are there some questions you'd like to ask?
To help you interpret.
I have all I need on these proper examinations.
No questions? Good. Dismissed. Get along with things. I'll do it.
Tell Mrs. Fitzgerald to keep some dinner warm.
Sure.
There's nothing the matter with them, but you shouldn't try to be so much of them.
Why not?
Because if everyone went in for an irregular education like that, there'd be no system left. There'd be chaos.
How about you grade those papers and see how much chaos we find?
You can use the dining room table.
Thank you.
If you don't mind, I'll look over your shoulder.
I do mind. Miss Brill.
You'll go.
You should go lie down for that. Dr. Burton said you should lie down for a little after dinner.
Dr. Burton's a milk goat, too.
A little rest won't hurt you.
Get him out of here!
Won't you ever wonder? I always wonder. Why not my bed? Or Dan's bed? Or Frank's bed? Or Martha's bed? Or Anne's bed? Why always Dad's bed?
He just attracts all of us. Come on in, Larry. Just my house.
I'm starved.
Well, go eat.
Don't worry. And don't think I didn't notice.
Notice what?
Remember that silly part of the movie? All about love. Saw you with hands.
That's a lie!
If anything like that happened, for maybe 10 seconds, it was because of the movie entirely involuntary.
What?
It was just that kind of movie.
Oh. See? Well, having you tag along is simply unendurable.
And I suppose you think it's durable for me? I'm starved to death.
Kid brothers.
In case you don't already know, I have 6 of them. 6 berserk kid brothers.
I already know.
Thank heaven.
Say, I bet you're getting hungry.
Hungry?
I made you miss dinner.
I miss dinner all the time. I hate dinner. In fact, if there's one thing in this world that I don't care if I miss, it's dinner.
I don't seem to be very hungry either.
You're not?
Of course, I had an awful lot of popcorn.
And gumdrops.
But that never interfered with my appetite before. Say, do you like to go to a dance?
I mean, I could probably fit it in, depending on when the dance is.
Tonight. Don't want to see me.
It just happens tonight. I'm free.
Well, I'll change you back to you in half an hour. I'm glad your dad's an old-fashioned girl that can go out to school night.
School night? Wait, Larry, there's someone I have to check with first.
Some other boy?
He's male.
I didn't think you're that kind that smells a fellow while she can see if she get a better date.
I'm not. It's not that at all. Really, Larry, I'd love to go with you. It's just, well, I have to get through a short exam first, and like I told you.
Honestly.
But I'd rather go to a dance with you than with anyone.
That's different.
And again, the minute my back was turned.
You don't have to sneak up on me like that. You might cough or something.
You try coughing with a mouthful of peanut butter. I gotta tell Dad we're back.
Wait! Bill! Mother said not to worry Dad with unimportant worries.
Whichever's going to worry him.
I hope he doesn't get your father mad.
He won't.
He's better than
that. I heard about your father.
Lots of people hear about Dad and his work.
It wasn't exactly about his work.
The way he eliminates waste motions and things like that. What'd you hear?
To be honest, I was almost afraid to come here.
No!
I didn't know whether I was going to date or not.
You haven't been listening to that little cheerleader, that Josie.
scales.
How'd you know?
The things that boy says about my father. Why, he'd say anything.
He would.
You'd think my dad was some kind of monster, when actually, he's friendly, agreeable, witty, has one of the sweetest tempers, and...
So she's back, is she?
And those stories are just absurd.
I'm glad to hear it.
What took her so long?
He must be calling to someone. Someone at the back of the house. When Dad calls to the back of the house, you can also hear him at the front of the house.
I guess you can.
No reason you shouldn't come here.
You mean that boy's down there right now?
Just bring.
No, I won't shush.
Yes, I'd be kidding along.
I suppose you have.
Guess I better.
Wait! Larry, about the dance. I don't suppose. I mean...
Yes?
What I mean is... Will you be coming back?
Why, Jacob?
I asked you to the dance, didn't I? Well, be seeing you.
Be seeing you.
Look at her!
I told you if I started dressing like other girls, everything would be alright and I'd be popular.
Popular? Missing dinner? Dodging tests? By jingle, you've started painting yourself.
I haven't!
I can see the paint! Perfume?
Frank!
You started using perfume!
Now, Frank! She hasn't even had her dinner yet.
It's her fault. Perfume.
Just one dab. Why not? It isn't painting or makeup, and it smells so good.
Why not? Because it stinks up the good fresh air. That's why not. You're going to wash it off.
Oh, Dad!
Don't you know what men think when they smell perfume on a woman?
I only know what one man thinks. He thinks I should wash it off.
Thinks? Nothing! Get in there and take that examination!
She's going to eat something first. I don't want to eat. I want to get the exam over with first. I've got something to do later.
Probably something.
Why do I have to have a brother tagging along when I go to a movie with someone? It's intolerable. Really, I don't know why any boy bothers with me.
Well, I know, even if you don't. And that's why your brother goes along.
Supposing I wanted to go to a dance. A really important dance that just happens, for instance, to fall on a school night.
Now we can talk about that when the time comes.
Mother? Dad?
Enough nonsense. Perfume, painting your face.
It's awful.
Aren't you, Miss Bro?
And?
It's going to stay for me! I need to go to school!
I'll explain to your father later.
It's just color.
Your color is very nice.
There's a reason. I'd like to get going on that exam.
Who'd you go with?
That fullback, Larry. Mother, I had a wonderful afternoon.
I'm glad, but you should have stayed out so long. We worry, especially your father.
Why does Dad care so much? What if I do waste one afternoon?
He wants everything shipshape and efficient before he leaves for Europe. Besides, there's this test.
Why did they have to send that miss?
I'm sure she's a fine teacher. I'll tell her you're here.
What's up? What's going on?
Larry asked me to dance. He's coming right back for me.
Are you crazy? It's a school night. What will you tell Dad?
I don't know. I'd better get that exam over with first. Is it tough?
The same old IQ stuff. It's a snack. Especially for Miss IQ of Montclair High.
I wish I could be Miss... something else.
You're stuck with it. For once, your IQ will be put to some good use. I can't wait to see Miss Rolls' face when she grades your paper.
I have a feeling she really wants to bear down with her red pencil.
Even I can have a trouble with the written part.
In the word association test, it's nothing. She just shoots bad words at you.
Swell, I'm in an awful rush.
You know, if I were to tell you the 5 words in the test, you could really pour it on her, wouldn't she ask?
Well, don't.
Golly, her mouth was dropped wide open.
I'd better get in there.
You know, if every time she popped a word at you, you could pop back a whole string of answers. A whole bundle of associated words.
Of course, it wouldn't be right to tell in the words in the text.
No, it wouldn't. And I'd better get a move on.
It would be wrong to tell her that the first word is knife.
Don't.
or that the second word is black.
Please!
Foot, hair, fur.
You shouldn't have told me.
No, you certainly shouldn't have told her that the words on the test are knife, black, foot, hair, and bird. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Gee, I'm sorry. And put them out of your mind. Try to forget that the five words are knife, black, foot, hair, and bird.
Forget them after the way you've been drumming them in.
Good night.
I'm already thinking of the answers. Why did you do a thing like that?
Aren't you ever going to get down to business?
Right now.
Why your mother told you to see to the babies?
We were seeing to them.
Until a motorcycle passes the house.
I think motorcycles are wonderful. You can make a lot of noise with a motorcycle.
And she's breezing through the test.
About time she is.
I think she has a crush on one of the boys at school.
Boss, here are the charts I've worked out. Rotations and duties, records of results. I want this all functioning before I...
Do you really have to go? I really wish you wouldn't go. Dr. Burton says...
Dr. Burton. What we need to do is concentrate on a way to knock a little sense into our problems.
They're perfectly normal. At least, they want to be.
They want to be wasting a lot of time. And time's too precious.
Is it really so important to have this management conference?
A conference like this gives me a chance to explain motion study to the world. The world could stand some efficiency. Besides, it could be awfully good for business. It costs a lot to run a family.
Remember when we first talked about the family we'd have? Our wedding day? You said we'd have a wonderful family. A great big family.
I warned you. Children from the basement to the attic. From the floorboards to the chandeliers.
And when we used to go on our Sunday walks, we looked like Mr. and Mrs. Piper.
Mrs. Piper, shake hands with Mr. Piper. Mr. Piper, meet Mrs. Piper.
And when I asked you how many children, just an estimate, you said many.
And that day we got on the train, you tried to make you appear so blasé, as if we'd been married for years.
And when I took off my hat, he gave up that loud whisper, "Good Lord, woman, why didn't you tell me your hair was that color?" And everyone turned to leer and wink.
I shouldn't have done that. It's just that I was so proud of you. I wanted everyone to look at you and know that you were my wife. All these work charts and committees are turning out fine. The family's getting so it runs itself.
You've thought of most everything, Mr. Piper.
Thank you, Mrs. Piper. I told you Anne would be back in time.
I don't think she's taking the test very seriously. She's just marking answers down the page as quickly as she can.
She said something about being in a hurry.
Perhaps there's something more important.
What is it?
You aren't supposed to leave the table until you're finished.
I am finished.
That's impossible.
It's finished.
You answered all the questions. The best you could.
Honestly, Dad, it was a snap. A snap? We'll just see how much of a snap it is.
You bet we'll see.
We'll just see how much. My goodness.
What's the matter?
There doesn't seem to be anything the matter.
You haven't found any wrong answers.
No, not yet.
Keep marking.
I will. Good heavens.
Yet?
No, not yet.
Just keep on marking.
I can't properly mark a paper under conditions like these.
Yet?
No, not yet.
Good job, Anne. We'll tell the whole family about this. I wish to make an announcement about your older sister.
Dad, she hasn't even finished marking it yet.
It seems to me as if your oldest sister has just completed a perfect examination.
But Mr. Gilbreth!
So far as we know, yet.
It's terrible!
And it looks to me as if she'll be graduating at the end of the semester.
What's this about graduating? Mr. Gilbreth, you were instructed not to mention that.
You already have her examination.
What is this? But she hasn't had the word association test yet.
Well, give it to her.
Here, now.
Yes, here and now.
All right, this is very irregular.
Are you ready now?
Oh, yes. She's ready.
I guess so.
You know how it's done. Answer with the word you associate. The first word, knife.
stab, wound, bleed, slip, rope, murder, disembowel, scream, shriek. My goodness, you must have an IQ higher than Nicholas Murray Butler.
I read a lot.
Next, black, velvet, night, pitch, tar, ebony. Next, foot, ribbon,
run, walk, shoe, stocking, dance.
Next, foot,
run, walk, shoe, stocking, dance.
Next, hair,
ribbon, hat, pigtail, shampoo, blouse.
Next,
egg, song, nest, foot.
But I didn't say the word, I just said next.
That's true.
Let me see. The word was bird. You said egg, song,
nest.
So you knew the word was bird.
How could she know?
You did know, didn't you? And you knew the IQ exam, didn't you?
No, it was just those words. It was a joke.
I see through this whole thing. You're all nasty little cheats.
Miss Brooke!
I told her the words.
And me.
Yes, you all cheated.
No, I'm the only one.
You're the only one who got caught. I see now how you all get so far ahead so fast. I'll certainly report this to the superintendent.
I didn't know the test meant anything.
This ends that graduation talk. And I'll recommend this grade-skipping you've done be thoroughly reviewed.
Just mine, no one else's.
The whole lot of you.
Gosh, Dad, I couldn't help it.
What do you mean you couldn't help it?
How could everything go so wrong? I had such a wonderful afternoon with the movies with Larry. He even asked me to a dance. This had to happen.
This sort of thing didn't happen until you got boys on your mind.
She's growing up. Other things are important, too.
Staying out all day? Missing dinner? Cheating on the examination? I can't have this whole program ruined by some boyfriend. This is the end of that nonsense!
You don't realize, Dad. When you're the youngest in the class, and you feel you have to stay right up in the top bracket, you miss out on other things, like leadership and sociability. Going to a dance with a boy you like.
Hi, Erin. Is Dan ready?
Oh, hello, Larry. I guess I can't make it.
Oh, the other date came through?
No!
It's perfectly okay. After all, it's up to you. Well...
I don't see why there's only time for studies and systems and organizing things and getting more efficient.
And I don't understand. Never mind.
I guess we just don't understand each other. I'll give a hand in the kitchen.
And...
It was the only thing to do. Really.
Should I, Dad?
We agree. Well, we better finish with the dishes.
Let's get back to the weeds. She'll be all right, Dad. I was paying the fence. It's still not too bad.
I couldn't let her just go out with some boy. It's a question of the whole program. That's much more important. And time is precious.
Of course it is, Dad. I better locate that dog now.
That's the whole thing. Time is so precious.
Well, they're all gone. With them all out of the living room, everything's so quiet and peaceful.
It certainly is. I hate it!
I think it occurred to Anne.
think something happened that afternoon. Something that made her suspect.
The way I remember, Anne spent the whole afternoon taking the review exam for the school board. Then she was so late coming home. Dad was so worried he might not get to see her.
She was late because she was waiting for the examiner to finish grading her exam. She just wanted something good to tell Dad before he left.
The misunderstanding with Dad, Anne really took it to heart. She felt so awful.
I think Dad, he felt even worse.
You could tell. When we put on a show for him that night to give him a big send-off, he laughed and acted as though he thought it was wonderful, but you could tell.
He kept watching for Anne.
It was his favorite show, too. Our imitation of him and Mother.
I still know it by heart.
You always played the role of Father, and I was Mother.
Remember?
Ladies and gentlemen, our first guest is Dr. Lillian Muller Gilbert.
Hello, Charlotte. I like your new hat. Why, Grace, you bobbed your hair. I won't be making any speech, but I will be glad to answer any of your questions.
Mrs. Gilbert, did you want a family of this size? And if so, why?
Any other questions?
Who wears the pants in your household?
Any other questions?
Thank you, Ms. Gilbert, for your enlightening answers.
Our next guest is Frank Bunker Gilbreth. Don't be frightened now. Please keep your seats. He promised to limit himself to only 2 hours, and not to mention the one best way to do work more than twice in the same sentence.
In the purpose of our convenience, I have divided my talk into 30 main headings, 117 subheadings. To commence on my first main heading.
Mr. Gilbert, the superintendent of this factory needs our advice at once.
Dear me, 3 seconds. Are you all sanitary? Are you all dry? Good, follow me.
You call this a factory?
Christmas! What football did you win? Are those your children or is this a picnic? They're my children and it's no picnic.
You like my Bolivians? Bolivians come cheaper by the dozen.
What do you think? Should I keep them all?
I think you should keep them all home. Jackie, take your fingers out of your mouth and tell this superintendent here what's inefficient about a drill press.
That fake drill press, huh?
Precisely. Lily, can you please explain this in simple language?
The position of the hand lever is such that there is waste motion both as the transport loaded and transport loaded. And the work plan of the operator is at 13 levels.
Heavens! Mr. Gilbert, tell your children to stop climbing over my machinery!
Don't worry. They're all trained engineers. I've even trained them myself.
Oh, look at the little Bolivian squatting over my buzzsaw. I can't watch him. Don't let him squatting lower.
The little rascal thinks it's a bicycle. Don't worry.
Ah! I lose more children in factories. Now, the rest of you, stay away from that bus saw, you hear me?
Someone please take a note of that, so we know how many places this effort has suffered.
Goodbye, sir.
It's your turn now. Do your one-man minstrel show.
No, let's wait till Anne gets home.
What if she doesn't get home in time?
She will.
Maybe she's having trouble with the examiner.
Miss Brill probably saw to that.
Nonsense. And if Anne is having trouble, it's just because they don't know how to put together a proper examination. Some teachers just don't know their business.
Aren't you going to do any minstrel show for us? Your father had some last minute things to attend to. Please, just do a little, Daddy.
Too much on my mind. Really.
But we won't be singing for a long time.
You always do that part of the show.
I just don't much feel like it.
Anne!
Hello, Dad. I didn't mean to be late.
How'd you do?
Did you show that Miss Brill and her school board?
They haven't finished marking my paper.
You took so long. I was beginning to worry.
Dad, it was a hard exam. I don't know how I did, but I tried my best, though. My really best.
Of course you did. I was just worried you wouldn't be home in time.
I set up snack food. No decent food on trains. His ice cream cookies for the rest of you.
Yay, everybody!
Glad you finished up and got home.
Oh, I went all the time anyway. I wouldn't want anything.
I bet you made them feel foolish for insisting on a review examination.
I don't know.
Of course you did. All you had to do was get the foolishness out of your head so you could do your best.
Dad, I did my best, but I still haven't gotten the foolishness out of my mind.
Anne.
Aw, Dad, she's been studying herself sick.
I can't help it.
I can't understand why you haven't more sense.
Dad!
I'm glad I got the oldest. By the time he gets to us, everything will be taken for granted.
I don't see why he cares so much.
Sometimes it's like he's the strictest father in town.
Were there any calls for me? Or anything?
Larry,
did he say anything? Did you say anything?
A little. I helped your cause.
How?
Well, I didn't let him think you had just been studying for the exam all the time. That's so drab. I gave him something colorful to think about.
What?
About all your other dates.
No!
I'm not so dumb. The next time Motorcycle Matt calls, you just keep your brilliance to yourself. What's the matter?
No, he'll think, oh, gosh, Mom.
I can't help it if neither of you understand men.
Don't understand men. Just watch how I handle Matt.
He won't even slow down.
He better.
What do you mean?
Well, you know where he swings in with that motorcycle of his? This is the last time he swings. You gave me the idea.
What idea?
Nails and broken glass.
I was joking.
We better warn him.
I think he missed.
You're going to see it every day.
Do you have $1 million, Daddy?
No. I have a million. million children instead. Somewhere along the line, you have to choose between the two.
I'll put it up later. I can explain what it means.
Later this afternoon. Do you like ice cream anymore?
Me!
Mrs. Piper, come along with me while I say goodbye to the babies.
What toys are you going to bring back for them, Mr. Piper? Slide rules.
My, Mrs. Piper, what a wonderful suggestion.
Just the tire and that mud guard.
What?
The motorcycle.
Oh.
They cost money, you know.
Maybe Ernie and I can pay for the damages. Gradually.
It was pretty old and beat up anyway.
But whatever it costs, and yes?
How come you run around with college boys? I thought you were studying. I didn't think you're that type of girl.
I'm not.
You don't have to pretend with me.
I'm not pretending. I wouldn't pretend with you. I don't think people should pretend with people.
I don't either.
And again.
Shocking.
He certainly has a wonderful sense of timing.
I hope he doesn't upset my father. Larry, Dad's leaving it all. I'd better see if I can help with him.
Sure, I'll get along. You really don't have free fraternity pins, do you?
I mean, of course not. I won't have time for nonsense like that.
What do you mean?
Sometimes a person has to push ahead with important things. Sometimes there are reasons.
Going to a dance with me? That's not important.
You don't understand. I didn't understand myself.
What?
Reasons. I can't explain. There's so much I'll have to do. I won't have much time.
Not even for senior prom?
You mean you're asking? It wouldn't be right.
Don't you get the door anymore?
Dad, I didn't hear it.
You weren't listening.
Hello, Mr. Gilbert.
I thought you wanted to go to a dance.
I do. But
looks to me as if I have an eldest daughter. Just about grown up. I wonder. Good heavens!
Who is it?
Won't you sit down?
I understand you're leaving, so I'll be brief.
Did you mark my paper?
The superintendent marked it himself.
Yes?
It wasn't my idea to come here.
About what?
The examination.
Let's have it. I catch a train in a few minutes.
That's why I was sent right over. She may fool others, but she doesn't fool me.
What was my mark?
I'm getting to it.
Did she pass?
Yes.
Was it a good paper?
Yes.
Was anything wrong with her paper?
No.
Yeah.
There's no more question about when she graduates.
I was told to tell you she's to graduate the end of this semester.
By jingo, I knew it!
Hey, that's swell.
Now, if you'll excuse me.
Thank you, Miss Burrow.
19 times 36.
Really?
19 times 36.
I'm not taking a test. Good day. It's 684.
I'm so glad. I was worried.
Nonsense. Your sister did wonderfully.
Thank you. Knew she would.
Insisted she take the examination. Forced it upon her.
Dad, I didn't really do it the first time.
I know. Marvin Ernie already explained. I haven't felt this good in years.
And I have to get out of home.
I'm glad you came over.
About the prom?
What I was trying to say before Miss Brill interrupted me. It looks to me as if you're growing up.
She is. More than you think.
And when a girl's growing up, it doesn't hurt if she goes to a few dances.
It's all right. I promise I won't let it ever interfere with my studies or anything.
Easy now. I believe you.
I hope you have a nice trip. And don't worry about Anne going to prom or anything.
You bet I won't. I'm sending Gilbert along with you.
Sure. It's really something the way you taught them.
Would you like to learn how to multiply cubic numbers in your head?
Never mind, Jackie.
Goodbye. Be seeing you.
Be seeing you.
It's getting late. I've had Frank put your bags in the car already.
Good. Bye, Jingo. My last official act before leaving is to make your mother head of the family council. All those in favor?
Aye.
Your mother is now the new chairman.
Dad, before you go, there's just one thing I don't understand.
Just one?
Well, I think I know why you want us getting ahead of things. But everything you do, all your work to save time, what I don't understand is, what are you trying to save time for?
For work, if you love that best. For education. For beauty. For art. For mumbly pay, if that's where your heart lies. For where your heart lies, that's what you save time for.
Right now, this is the happiest time in the world.
No. Enough nonsense. Get on with things. And by Jingo, behave yourselves.
Thank you.
Yeah, I did.
Just forgot to work on one.
Or somebody was having a bad day. These kids.
other. And when I was sick, they called me. They had me.
Love it.
Like, that's one day. First day, Dylan said he was just going to leave, and he had had a bad day, and he's like, you need a hug. So he gave me a hug. Every time. I have to say something about every one of these kids. Come on, you're here every time. You are just, like, you're just saying, you called me.
You see how far we go with these
guys. Yeah.
Jesse's